addressing the rights and inclusion of persons with disabilities has emerged as a significant human rights and foreign policy issue in the 21st century. There are 1 billion people with disabilities around the world, and 80% of them live in developing countries such as Ghana.
As I reflect on the journey of my life, I think about how God directed me to Nkranza in the Brunkahafu region of Ghana for a workshop. I had a burden for my town to give from their hearts, and not out of duty.
Lead me when you're not strong.
Here's little Abby, a mentally retarded person who has suffered this illness from childbirth. And by the fear of their mother losing her, she has kept her home out of ignorance. When they are sent us here in Nkranza for such illness, with my help, little Abby's mother has agreed to send her ward to a center for proper care. So help her, God.
Over the years, the aged have almost always been overshadowed due to their old age and weakness.
I made my kind-hearted projects to help the aged, disabled, and the needy clear to the aged I visited with my mother.
She was very pleased with Mr. Yausoro for taking it upon himself to bring out the best in the aged, the needy, and the disabled. She believes that whether aged, disabled, or needy, we all are humans and have the same capabilities and mindset to be treated equally. She would be very grateful if she could get some kind of assistance to be able to make something out of this life before she joins her ancestors. It was amazing how they twist and turn in their wheelchairs during the training section. Indeed, disability is never inability. These ones have shown the excellent works of how God takes care of a dog without a tail. This shows how best they can work together with the abled ones in any sector of the job economy.
But first of all, Not only say yeah to having fun, but it's only creating awareness. Because the Mudu was saying the name says, you will reach across the ball basketball. And you know, every day, every year, you move fast, you be a be basso. Now, that should be no. Every year, I'm a crime here, then, So a year I have boss basketball day. If you are dancing a power, BB, I have similar to me, yeah, yeah. And let the basketball we back from the old class, I went 21. Now, I'm here.
Mr. Richard Yao, sorry for the explanatory details. How dedicated he was, and ever ready to do his possible best to support the dream and also encourage the people.
Oh yeah, you must so experienced. I'm also a bad young man. You say, I'm a good.
Master, my mother can say, said I am working on. Mama, my hobby is here. Can say, if you are, you know, for her, no one see a basketball. No go. Said you can so full pad and super. Said you will. Wabre, wabre. So I'm feeling young couple of one. When you are doing, you say, me for so I could do the beer when I'm a pen. Anami Ben.
As part of Mr. Yao Soro's project reaching to the poor and needy, he also organized eating competition to awarding the kids. Since meeting the needs of the poor and needy were his priority, he commenced the whole ceremony with laughter and smile on the faces of the youth and adults. Aiko, bienvenue. Welcome. Thank you so much, Mr. Yao Soro, for putting smiles on our faces.
Big occasion or activity requires the support of the big people in the society to make it successful. The MCE of Nkranzaman, Honorable Stella Amwatima, arrived to give her support. She was welcomed as she took her seat. An avenue through which persons with disabilities can be treated equally, building self-esteem and confidence that enhances participation in everyday life.
Yeah,
Honorable Stella Amwatima gets the ball in the basket to usher in the big game.
This is the new Vision for Disabilities Inc. USA sponsored wheelchair basketball shootouts between Ashanti Region and Bronkahafo Region at Nkranza Local Authority Junior High School on Friday, 6 March 2015. Touching lives with a gift can remain in their hearts for a lifetime. It makes a difference to show love and concern for humans as we share. Mr. Richard Yalsoro, a disabled but a philanthropist, has seen the need of giving towards the good of the disabled society. The Ghana Society of the Physically Disabled Craft Production Training Center, located in Nkranza. It was instituted by Mr. Richard Yalsoro to help bring out the best in the physically disabled, to create jobs and also to make them equal to the fit ones.
If within the ambulance force, you be a medical from Ghana, but you're going to be a medical technology.
Papa is with the prime starting here. Now we don't know how to make one of my.
Where are my family from here?
Also, the boy. My boy be free. What the boy be say? Project is a movie soprano. And I'm also a mother sign. Because I'm not going to be in the cooperation. The cooperation is between you and I. I'm going to say that. I'm going to go to the hospital.
Lead on me when you're not strong. I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on.
My name is Richard Yao Soro. From Nkransa here in the Brunhafo region. I'm about 35 years old, and I'm a founder and president for New Vision for Disabilities, USA. And our aim is to help people with disability and disadvantaged people, providing them with a job and financial aid to go to school, those who need them. And these are my beautiful family. This is my wife, Lydia Ose, and I got my two kids and my mom at the back of the vehicle. I'm here in Ghana right now to help look at people who might need help, like going to school or improve their vocational skills or vocational trade and all that. This organization, the New Vision for Disabilities, has come to change the people's perception. And what I mean by that is how people look at disabled people. Do they think we can drive as I'm driving with my hand controls here? Do they think it's possible for a handicapped person to drive? Do they think a handicapped person can travel overseas to make their life for their living? Do they think a handicapped person can do something better than going to the street and beg for money? And that is the reason why we have formed this non-profit organization to come help improve the actual living standards of persons with disability, and most especially people who are disadvantaged in the country.